Hello friends, welcome back again to my YouTube channel, and on today's tutorial we are going to look at superficial area method of approximation. We are going to approximate the cost of a building using superficial area method. This is the type of method which caters for the floor area or uses the floor area and also use the perimeter, the internal perimeter or the internal dimensions of the building. Now we have a question here which says, using the data below, calculate the approximate cost of the building using superficial method. We've been given the data. The wall thickness is 215 millimeters. Unit cost for the warehouse is 5,000 and for the offices is 12,000. Now let's look at the building that we need to approximate its cost. That is what we have. For the elevation, that is how it looks. And then for the floor plan, this is what we have. We have the warehouse. You can see the warehouse and you can see the office. The width is 10 meters for both the warehouse and the office. And then the length of the office is 22 meters. And then for the warehouse is 22 meters. And then for the office is 4 meters. And then the height is 3 meters, and then the height of the roof is also 3 meters. But now we are not using cubic meters, so let this one not confuse you. Remember, we have different methods of approximation. We have the cubic, we have the story enclosure, we have the approximate quantities, we have the functional unit method, and then we have this superficial method. Now let's look at what we need. So we've said we are going to use internal length, internal dimension for us to be able to get the area. So we are going to start with the warehouse. So the length of the warehouse we've said is 22 meters, yes, that is the length. So we need to get the internal length. So it's 22 minus the wall thickness was 215, so that is 0.215. Remember, there are two, this side and this side. We have two walls. So we subtract that one for us to be able to get the internal length, which is 21.5 meters. The width is 10 meters. The width is 10 meters. So 10 minus also the walls, that is 2 into 0.215, that gives us 9.57. Now, since we have the internal length and the internal width, we can be able to proceed to get the area. Area is length times width. That is 21.57 times 9.57, giving us 206.42 square meter. When we were given the data, we were given the data for the unit cost per square meter, and we were told for the warehouse is 5,000, and then for the offices is 12,000. So now, since we have the total square meter, we can go ahead and find the total cost of the warehouse. So what we have for the warehouse is the area was 206.42, and then we multiply by the cost per meter square, that is 5,000, giving us 1,032,124.50. That is for the warehouse. Now we proceed and find for the offices. The internal length is four. Yes, the internal length of our office here is 4 meters. That is the length. And then, that is the external length. So we find the internal length, that is 4 minus the walls, that is 2 into times 0.215, giving us 3.57. The internal width is 10, the same as the one that we had for the warehouse. So we subtract that one, we get 10 minus 2 times 0.215, that gives us 9.57. So area will be 3.57 times 9.57, giving us that 4.16. The cost per square meter is 12,000, so we multiply that by the area. That 4.16 times the area, which is 12,000, giving us 409.978.80. Now for us to get the total cost of that plan, we are going to take the cost of the warehouse, which was 1,032,124.50, and then we add to the cost of the office, which is 409,978.80, giving us a total of 1,442,102.50 shillings. So guys, that is how we calculate the cost of the We estimate the approximate cost of that building using superficial area method. Thank you guys for your time. Until next time, bye bye.